All right. Well, welcome. Welcome to the Sanctuary. Welcome to the Epiphany Center for the Arts. And welcome to live music with actual live people. So give yourselves a round of applause. Come on. I'm Mike Jeffers, Director of Entertainment here at Epiphany Center. On behalf of David Chase and Kimberly Rochelle, the two co-founders, we welcome you to the Sanctuary. This is one of our four live music venues. I think some of you probably, when you came up the stairs, peeked in next door to our largest hall, which is Epiphany Hall, where you can do concerts up to 960 down there, and all sorts of different genres. Up here, we do, well, this is part of our fall music series still. We're not into the winter yet, even though it feels like the winter. So we do live music Thursday nights, jazz. Here we go. Friday nights, blues. Saturday nights, we do a spotlight in the Sanctuary. We put a specific spotlight on a specific genre of music, blues, rock, Latin, jazz. We actually had a 10-piece reggae band up here. We had a big band up here at one point as well, so it was a very versatile space. And then on Sundays, we actually do an acoustical music series here in the Sanctuary, 3 o'clock this Sunday. You know, I have to keep track of all these dates. This Sunday, we actually have Giuliani Ensemble up here. All the information's on epiphanychi.com, so we encourage you to visit us many, many times. Also, part of the performance aspect up here in the Sanctuary is we do a four-camera live stream of every show. So tonight we're going to be live streaming the show. And what I always suggest everyone to do, and thanks, by the way, thanks to our good partners, ourconcerts.live, which is a platform that launched similarly, very close to when we launched back last fall, when we first opened this room specifically. And they're part of a 15-package Performing Arts Center package. So if you subscribe for $12.95, you get to watch performances from 15 different performing arts centers throughout the country, including this one. So you get all the shows four nights a week from here and all across the country. Or you can just buy a single ticket as well. And they're up for 48 hours. If you buy, I think starting tomorrow morning, you can go back and listen to this show and buy this show for 48 hours. And so what I always suggest is, I think many of you met our spectacular bartender, Terry, back there at the bar. You can give her a round of applause. Because if you give her a round of applause, she gives me a drink, so everybody can applaud her. But I would suggest you visit Terry as many times as you can tonight, because she gets very lonely back there. So, you know, just continue to say hi to Terry throughout the evening. And after that, you'll probably say, man, that was a great show. But I really wonder what they played, because I visited Terry so often, I can't really remember all that well. So tomorrow you can buy the live stream and see the entire show again on epiphanychi.com. A couple other items. I think some of you actually got here early enough. We do a golden hour here, 4 to 7, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday now. And that's downstairs, free admission downstairs in the cafe bar, where it's half-price bottles of wine, two-for-one appetizers, $4 craft beers. Tonight we had Brazilian jazz, tomorrow blues. Saturday we do a house music thing. And Wednesdays we just launched holiday karaoke throughout December. So how about that? Come on back on Wednesday and sing Jingle Bells all night long. So come on back. I heard it last night, folks. I heard it last night. And then, now, I don't want you to laugh. I don't want you to jeer. But we also do a Bears watch party here. They're going to win at some point. They're going to win at some point, so you want to be here when it happens. But actually, this Sunday, we're doing an open house for the entire place. It's a holiday open house. So at 2 o'clock, we have mezcal tasting. We have classical music up here at 3. We have the tree lighting at 6 down in one of our larger spaces. And then, of course, we have the Bears at 7:20. We have a blues band at 5 o'clock. And best of all, starting at 5:30, we have a free chicken wing buffet all the way up through the Bears game. So at least if they're horrible, you're fed. You get to see some good food, and you get half-price drinks. So come on back. We look forward to having you. I got to do anything I can here. You know, we actually thought about just saying, you know, maybe we should just say we're a Packer bar and we would pack the place on Sunday. But we're like, no, we can't do that. That's just against everything. So, all right. Well, I'd like to bring the band up to the stage now. This is going to be really awesome. So Damani and the guys can come on up. And we're going to get ready to hit it here. This space from 1885 on the National Historic Registry. And I founded Chicago Jazz Magazine 20 years ago. That's how I ended up coming on here to become the director of entertainment. So jazz is near and dear to my heart. And myself, as a performer, I've played throughout the country. And I think that this is one of the finest intimate jazz rooms in the entire country, let alone Chicago. Church from 1885. You just don't ever have this kind of an experience for this kind of acoustical music. And having Damani, when Damani reached out to come in here and perform, We thought Thursday was perfect with our jazz series, and hearing the group on YouTube and on recordings did not do it justice, as we all know. So this is going to be a fantastic night. And ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Damani Phillips and company.
Thank you. What's happening, folks? Good evening. Oh, come on, man. That's real polite. What's happening? That's what I'm talking about. Understand, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be educational on a number of different levels. I'm going to start with the cultural. Understand that this is a reciprocal music. And if you are flat-footed, we'll call it, in the audience, we up here may reciprocate that and be flat-footed and playing. Now, nobody wants anybody to be flat-footed. So I'm hoping that you can help us out. Reciprocal energy, huh? Right? Hey, listen, if we can't have fun, what are we doing here? So listen, folks, on a serious note, thank you for being here this evening. It is an absolute pleasure to finally be able to play in Chicago under my own name, and more importantly, to be joined by a stellar cast of cats that is absolutely ridiculous. It is always a blessing and a curse to be the weak link in your own band, but I wouldn't have it any other way, though. It's just the way it's supposed to be. So speaking of which, let me make sure you know who these folks are up here, because these are names that, like I say, keep your eye out for, because you'll be seeing them quite often over the years here in the city and elsewhere. So let me start over here to the right. My colleague over at the University of Iowa, our professor of jazz piano, a monster composer. By the way, when this cat's not destroying the blues, guess what he's doing? He's writing operas that are about to be debuted in 6 months. That's what I'm talking about. Black excellence, ladies and gentlemen. This right here is Dr. William Menefield. Back here handling business on the bass, ladies and gentlemen. This is someone who I just recently came into communication with as we recorded my most recent CD. I didn't know that he was down in Indianapolis, but he came on up to Chicago in the recording session and formally announced his presence. And I think that you agree wholeheartedly as to why my ears perked up when I heard him. He's an absolute beast, and again, I feel completely fortunate to have him with me. This, ladies and gentlemen, on bass is Mr. Brandon Meeks. And over chan to the left, right, is my main man. Man, we were trying our very best to get that man over to University of Iowa. I swear to you, man, I learned the true art of political maneuvering, trying to get a space for this guy, but unfortunately, the stars did not align for that to happen, but I'm happy that the stars did align for this man to join us tonight. An absolute monster on the drum set in any number of a variety of styles, and that's kind of why I love playing with him at every opportunity I have the chance to. This over here, a professor of jazz drums at Ball State University in Muncie, Indiana. This lady and gentleman is Mr. Cassius Goens. Sorry for that long intro, y'all, but it's important that you know who you're dealing with. Critically important. It's not a, don't worry about me. We'll get to me later on. It's about this chum, right? So speaking of which, like I say, we came up to Chicago in July to record my most recent album, No More Apologies, which is actually for this quartet that you see here and a 8-piece string rhythm section. Or eight-piece string section. I'm hoping that my dream will come true of having those 8-string players join us for a gig somewhere in Chicago before it's all said and done. But for tonight, I hope that the rhythm section that held that album down will suffice just fine. We're gonna talk a little more about the album, but this tune is one of the songs off of the album, one of my original compositions that I wrote a long time ago, but brought it back out and gave it a new kind of spin.
And I hope that you enjoy. This is my composition entitled Sunset's Last Embrace. Thank you.
That's what's up. You know what? It's small things in this world that matter. When that grease hits you just right, you can't help but go, ow. Then you know that cooking is coming together properly. So we are truly humbled and truly appreciative. Next one we're gonna do, is one written by a guy named Lou Marini, but it was really made popular by the recently late great trumpet player, Roy Hargrove, one of the true champions of the music, and one of those cats that that was trying to politely remind us that the music needs to be connected to something other than the theory and the mathematics of it all. It needs to be connected to people and community. And so his whole vibe was trying to make the music accessible to everyday folks without having to necessarily water it down to become something very different than it originally was intended to be. And so if I can be like that guy when I grow up, I'll be all right with it. This is Lou Marini's tune, popularized by Jesus Christ, Roy Hargrove, entitled Starmaker. That's what we call an Alzheimer's moment, y'all. I'll own it. I'll own it fully. Alzheimer's / long semester. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. William Menefield. Get him. Thank you. Can I get up? You can ask. How about we do this? Let me get a switch.
Thanks, folks. Once again, Lumarini Starmaker. You're not a fluffy tune. Beautiful, that's what I mean. I'm sorry. This is jazz cat adjectives right there. Fluffy, we get real colorful and creative with words. That's what we gotta do though. Man. Man, that is so pretty, bro. The hardest part about it is funny. The tune's not hard. It's not hard in the literal sense, but it's hard in the figurative sense, because if you don't treat it with its proper respect, you know, all of the fluffiness sucked out of the song. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. Once again, Lumarini Star Maker. Yes. All right, so, sorry, it took me a second there. So some of you know me, some of you don't, but my guy, my favorite guy in the jazz world on planet Earth is a cat named Cannonball Adderley. You might know him from the Kind of Blue record with Miles Davis. He's the alto player on that. That's just the tip of the iceberg. This cat right here is an absolute heathen on that alto saxophone. And pretty much any album of his that you pick up, it is going to be a guaranteed winner. And I can verify because I have every single one of them. I'm not joking. Back in the days of CDs, it's all downstairs in my basement, all lined up. And I still got a CD player, too. But this is one from his catalog that rarely sees the light of day. And I think it is ridiculous that of all the songs that are out there in the jazz idiom that we keep playing the same songs over and over and over again. So I can't fix it in the grand scale, but on a smaller scale, I can most certainly make sure that we do our part. So this is a tune written for his band by a pianist named Victor Feldman, an absolute monster tune. This is a Feldman's tune entitled Lisa. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Cassius Goens on the drums. It's funny how that worked. That man just walked in here, pulled the pin out the grenade, just dropped it off on the floor, and sashayed on the way into the sunset. That's why I appreciate him, though. You know what I'm saying? Because we have no choice but to get the hell out the way, yeah? My leg is missing. Man. This set went ridiculous. No, not just yet, bro. Not just yet. I'm getting there, though, but not just yet. So, as I told you, just put out an album here about a month ago, and it is surprised even me. I thought it would be do okay, but it is, as we say, growing legs. And when people that you don't know are buying it, you're like, who is this dude? I don't know. That's a good sign. So, and this is all from word of mouth. This is very grassroots, AKA Obama. You know what I'm saying? Uh-oh, did I start trouble? Uh-oh. Did I just put a grenade in the middle of the floor myself? Grassroots efforts, though. Just, you know, if you like it, tell a friend. And it has literally exceeded my expectations. And this seems to be one that is one of the favorite tunes on the album. It was written by a saxophone player named... Braxton. Braxton Cook, thank you. Cat out of Los Angeles. And it is a fantastic tune. And he wrote it in homage to Trayvon Martin. And it you know how it is, some tunes you're like, oh, that's a pretty good tune, but some when you hear it, like, all it takes is one listen and you're like, oh man, I need to have this for myself. And so I got in touch with this cat, literally, the beauty of social media. I actually sent him an IM on Instagram and made arrangements to secure the right to record his tune. He taxed the hell out of me, but I paid him, but I got the rights to do it. Yes, he did. Yeah, it's okay, but you know what, man? When you hear the recording of it, it was absolutely worth every dime that I paid for it just to have the chance to do this, and it literally is a beautiful tune. And when it resonates on multiple levels. So I'm beyond pleased to have the opportunity to share this tune with you. This is Braxton Cook's song entitled Him for Trayvon.
Take your time on the part in the middle. Don't feel rushed.
Thanks, y'all. Once again, Braxton Cooks, him for Trayvon, killing tune, huh? Man, sweating like a serious, but it takes a little bit out of you when you at least give your very best to make it right, because you can't just play that one kind of sort of. Got to do that one proper justice, or at least attempt to. So Braxton Cooks, him for Trayvon. If you don't know it, go check it out. I'm happy to share, but you know what I mean. Always go back to the source, my brother. All right, we're coming up on the end of all this. I don't believe it, man. It goes quick. We'll do two more for you if that's okay. We might go a little bit over. I hope the establishment doesn't get mad at us. So this one is written by the great piano player, Herbie Hancock. One of his trademark tunes that, more importantly, with a healthy slathering of them blues in it. It's part of what makes it attractive to us here. So this is Herbie Hancock's tune entitled Drifting. Thank you.
Thank you.
Just let me handle the business, then we can get out of there. All right.
All right. Man, see, now you know what the debate was about up here, because we are technically at the end of the evening, but he warned me that, you know what I'm saying, you can't dip your toe into the waters of Lake Minnetonka and not go ahead and dive all the way in. And he kind of had a point. So, yeah, but before we dive on into this, first and foremost, thank you to the establishment here, Epiphany Center for the Arts, for having us. It's been an absolute honor to play here. Beautiful room, and we've been treated exceptionally well. These cats on stage with me, coming from all corners of the region, and I feel beyond honored and beyond fortunate to have these guys up here as allies in the fight, the musical fight that is. Speaking of which, those guys are over here on the drums, coming all the way up from Indianapolis, Indiana. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Mr. Cassius Goens. Directly behind me, also hailing from Indy. Like I say, somebody who I've just recently come into contact with, but with any luck, good Lord, as my mom said, good Lord willing, the creek don't rise. We will find a way to make another meeting happen again with us on the bandstand very, 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 very soon. This, ladies and gentlemen, on bass is Mr. Brandon Meeks. Over here to my right is part of my Iowa brethren. He and I come from over in the cone, over in the next state. But let me assure you that as they planting that corn, we putting a little bit of that Lawry's in there. Right there next to the seed, you know what I'm saying? So and a little bit of that. Anyway, I'm not gonna start. You get what I'm trying to say. You may think one or two things about Iowa, but my hope is that my colleague and I will be constructively changing your opinion on that day by day, month by month, and year by year. Ladies and gentlemen, over here on the piano, Dr. William Menefield. All right. So we got to at least play the melody, don't we? Yeah, that would be sacrilege. I can see my mama, boy. That one word and that sideways look that just destroys your universe? Yeah, I see it right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and give her what she want before she pull out a belt. Let's dive on in. It's just a snippet, just a snippet. You know what it is already. I only have to introduce a tune. Let's get it. Thank you. I'm just gonna let that sit right charm. No point in trying to force the issue. Let that love just sit right there and marinate, brew. It's been a pleasure to play for you. We appreciate you spending your Thursday with us. Don't you change the key, because I don't think I can sing that high. On the drums, that is Cassius Goens, y'all. On the bass, that there is Brandon Meeks. The good Reverend Dr. William Menefield on the key. And I am Dr. Damani Phillips.
But see, but seriously, we're just kidding around, but spontaneity, huh?
Yeah, listen, we truly do appreciate you coming out and spending a slice of your Thursday with us. We get that this is a weekday and most folks got to get up and go to work. And these folks who are here want to go home to their family, so we don't want to be that band that has them here till midnight when they should have been off by 10. So nobody likes that band is what I'm trying to get at. So thank you folks again for being here. Listen, if you enjoyed what you heard tonight, again, I have this brand new project. This is the actual band from that project with an added splash of 8-string players on top of it. Equally funky, just with a little bit of finesse sprinkled on top, like seesaw.
Right.
So if you're interested in that or any of my other projects, please come up and see me. Whatever I got in my bag, I'm willing to let it go for $10. So if you are interested, please come up and see me. And even if you're not interested, come up and see us anyhow. Come say hello. This is real simple stuff, right? If we've officially met each other tonight. You were in the room and you heard and you stayed for the whole concert. We met each other. So come on up and make that introduction official. Come up and say hello. In the meantime, thank you folks again. We wish you the very best for a safe journey home. And please, we hope to see you again at a venue in Chicago sometime soon. Peace and blessings. Thank you, folks. Thank you, folks.
Damani Phillips. Damani Phillips. I'd like to thank everyone for watching on our concerts.live. Everyone watching in the live stream. Guys, don't go away. You got to come up and meet them. By the way, you mentioned from Iowa to Chicago, the only thing I know tonight that I learned about people from Iowa is that they are some badass jazz musicians. So give it up one more time. You can come back. You can come back. But thank you again for being here. Hang out, chill out, come and see them, and we hope to see you again soon. Thank you so much.